Okay, here's something I found in a local store the other day that I've never seen before. I've seen a channel on YouTube review one of these or a couple different ones like years ago. It's like the Wolf Pit is on YouTube. He had some of these. They're basically a meat pie in a can, or this one's the vegetable one, but they make like a like bean and kidney one or something. There's a steak one, mushroom something one. Anyway, you can look up this company, Frey Bentos. They're an English company, but there's a little, like a small little section in the local grocery store that sells all kind of like English stuff or stuff from the UK. And this came in the other day. I'd never seen this before, but it was like $6, which I think in England it's a couple dollars, but I think some people in the States that have got them like shipped to them that end up costing them like $10. So anyway, but this is the Frey Bentos. The name comes from, I guess it's a city in Uruguay. It's like it's a place where there was a huge metal or a meat packing plant back. It's been closed a while, I guess, but it was a lot of like corned beef and stuff came from there that was eaten during the wars and all this kind of stuff. But anyway, so it's kind of an interesting history of this name and some of this stuff. Anyway, but so this one's the vegetable. It's like Balti, I don't know, whatever you, how you pronounce it. It's an Indian, guess like a curry dish. I think there's one here that has chicken as well in it. But more or less, you cut the top off, and then bake it in the oven. It has all the instructions on here. They put these stupid stickers on the back of them because I think it's to put, so it has French on it or something, and it sort of converts the nutritional facts or something, because the way the English have it written is kind of weird. But so it kind of covers up the instructions and stuff, so it's kind of annoying. But I can peel the sticker off here. Doesn't really say anything, but just sort of has the percentages for the daily intake for, yeah, this is gonna be annoying. More or less, you cut the top off, then you cook it. You see, preheated oven, 450 degrees or 230 Celsius for 25 to 30 minutes. Or gas mark 8. It says even. Get this sticker off here. But the crust is should rise and get brown on top and stuff. So sticker's a bugger. I don't know why they put this on here. They stick the damn thing somewhere where it doesn't do anything. Because they're supposed to be the. How long it's supposed to last is under this too, so. But it's quite funny. They actually give you, like when you move the lid, they actually recommend what type of can opener you use. It's kind of strange. I can get this friggin'. Maybe I'll come back if I get this peeled off. Okay, so I got more of the label peeled off. It says it was best before 8. 2022, so that lasts quite a while. So you could, it'd kind of nice if more kinds of these came in, because the other ones sound a bit more interesting than this vegetarian one. But anyway, worth giving this a try. So yeah, so they do mention, let's see, highly recommend both. There's a Brabantia Central line or OXO Good Grip openers. Place open can on baking tray, and then just cook for 25 minutes, as I said before. And store in cool, dry place. There's the stuff that's in it, but it's covered up with this mess. And the sticker, you couldn't hardly read. Well, now you can't read it at all, but anyway. And then there's, you can get in contact with Free Bento's Foods. What's that? Fushabers, Scotland? Fuckerber? I don't fucking know. What the fuck? Anyway, so we'll cook this thing up and then we'll give it a try and see what we think. So. Okay, here's some of that stuff on a plate. Got the crust was nice and browned up pretty quickly, actually. And there's a little bit of the crust that's underneath that's a little bit more, you know, undercooked stuff or whatever. And probably that's the best part. You can see what it looks like. It's got like peas and carrots and like that chunk of potato or something there. I'll try to get a little bit of it here and give it a try. Yeah, that's not too bad. Mostly sort of a tomato-y kind of flavor to it. And when I first opened the thing, it had kind of like a pizza sauce kind of smell to it, but that's kind of gone away now. A little bit of the crust here. It's really mild, actually. I suppose it's sort of a curry type dish, but it doesn't really have a whole lot of. It's like a super mild curry if it's there. It's not bad, though. Not too bad. I'm just gonna try some of the other ones. Got, it seems like it's a tiny little bit of spiciness to it now, but it did say mild on the can, so. Looking for something that's vegetarian and different and fairly mild. This seems pretty good. Enjoy that. It's pretty good. Anyway, if you can find that somewhere, hope I can find some of the other ones, because the meat ones would be good too, I think. So, anyway. Thanks for watching.